back to that Star Wars music, that might give you a hint that Christmas, of course, is as much, well, it's about lots of things, but it's also about films. Now, you know, for me, I would just sit and watch black and white movies from the 50s and I'd be in my element. But I have to say, I don't think television has got very much to offer us at the moment. So the cinema seems a pretty good choice. But who better to tell you than my next guest, Van Connor, who is a film expert. And Van is going to come here and tell us all about the film scene this Christmas. Good evening to you, Van. And first of all, thank you for joining us. Happy Christmas.
And a Merry Christmas to you as well, Nick.
Thank you. Now, what is going on? Did you hear, by the way, that intro of the Star Wars music? I don't know if they called you by then, but we're playing Christmas songs as we come in and out of, you know, top of the hour. And they put Star Wars on. That's not Christmas, is it? Come on.
You know, it kind of is to me. I'll be real honest. Last year they made an exception and they released Solo in the summer and it was out of sequence. And I just got used to the idea that Star Wars was part of Christmas.
It just felt wrong.
2015, I know I'm in the right and Disney would agree with me.
Well, now tell us, I'm told reliably that this Boxing Day, for example, people are just as likely to go to the cinema as sit around eating cold turkey and cold ham. So what is there out there that we should be looking out for?
Well, this Boxing Day, we've got three new releases coming out. They're all various degrees of spectacle. You've got the counter-programming bit of family-friendly fun. That's Playing with Fire. That's the firefighter comedy starring John Cena. That's where there's a group of volunteer firefighters who take in three wayward kids whose parents are out of town and they rescue from a fire and naturally hijinks ensue. It's very Kindergarten Cop, very pacifier, very game plan. You know that one that all the action stars do when they want to have that token kid-friendly one with the white poster? You're the one they always do.
No, well, I assume they always do. I have to tell you, I was trying to keep up with that one because it sounded like these three kids had been abandoned, were found in a fire, and then the fire crews took them in.
No, basically, I think the parents go away for the weekend and there's a fire in the cabin and the kids just happen to get rescued by the firefighters at that holiday, on that holiday weekend, and they're sort of stuck there for like 3 days.
Hey, I see, but hang on, had they had all these checks you're meant to have, you know, as a responsible adult? I mean, you can't just pick up three kids, can you, and take them away, or am I just being a killjoy here?
I think you are, because it's John Cena. No one's letting John Cena near kids without knowing it's John Cena. We all love him. Trust John Cena.
Of course, and basically is that's released now, is it? It's just come out?
No, that is one for Boxing Day.
Okay.
You've also got two others coming alongside that. You've got a more traditional animated family effort called Spies in Disguise with Will Smith and Tom Holland.
Brilliant.
Sounds bonkers, but he's actually really, really good.
So come on, give us a clue.
So the idea is it's a spy comedy. It's animated. It's from 20th Century Fox, and they sort of Disney have acquired it through the Disney Fox merger. The idea is the world's slickest, suavest super spy is framed as a rogue agent by a terrorist, goes on the run, and has to find a way to hide from his usual colleagues. He has to find a way to hide from them, and he takes in a young sort of like a Q from the Daniel Craig Bond series type character who finds a way to make him feasibly undetectable. And that is by turning him into a pigeon, albeit a pigeon with the voice of Will Smith. So you can imagine how that plays out.
But it actually sounds fantastic. But you have to ask yourself, what are these guys on, these creative geniuses, when they come up with the idea of turning Will Smith into a pigeon?
Probably the same thing the guys who make the Saw movies are on, if we're honest.
But it does sound fun. And that rating, PG, is it something?
I believe that one's animated. I think that one might be a U, although I think it veers into PG territory at times. You've also got a lot more of a traditional film out alongside those two, and a bit more for the grown-ups, and it is of course the latest adaptation of Little Women, which has been written and directed for the screen this time around by none other than Greta Gerwig. It stars Emma Watson, it stars Saoirse Ronan, it stars Florence Pugh. You can't get more top tier than this. You can't get more zeitgeisty than this. It's gone meta, it's gone extremely feminist, it's gone a bit more inventive with the narrative. We all know the Alcott story. I think most of us remember it from the version of the 90s that starred Winona Ryder and Christian Bale, and this is a new, lot more highbrow an interpretation of it.
But this is, as you say, it's a well-known story. It's also about the third or fourth remake, isn't it? Or I'm not up to date on films, but from the original, I thought this had been remade at least once before already. Or am I completely wrong on that? Tell me, I'm wrong.
One of those like Jane Eyre or something like that. They do have to adapt for the screen about once every 20 years, like clockwork. It just needs refreshing from time to time.
And a big film for our former Harry Potter star, of course. She's actually Emma Watson. This was being touted as quite an important film for her. I seem to remember reading about a year ago.
Well, this is the thing, because Emma Watson really isn't in that many films when we stop and think about it. Like, I don't really remember what she did between The Bling Ring and this, but, you know, she is a high-profile figure because she does a lot of sort of real-world work with activism and charities and things like that, and obviously she's always a staple of the tabloids and the, you know, the sort of BuzzFeed-y, gossipy kind of site. It's something to be celebrated when she actually does return to the screen, because she is a good actress. I'd argue she has the second weakest role of any of the characters in this one. But, yeah, it worked. The rock star, though, is Florence Pugh. Always is.
Well, now, listen, I want to bring you back, if I may, just to Star Wars, because I read that even though this seems to be a successful film, its actual takings are down, its numbers are down. What's been going on here?
Right, so noticeably, Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker, which is the culmination of the entire Star Wars saga to date, it's noticeably drastically underperformed in China. It's not made anywhere near as much money as, for instance, The Last Jedi made, because The Last Jedi was riding very high off the wave of, you know, The Force Awakens resurrecting the franchise. There's a lot of division in the fan base after The Last Jedi. People were very unhappy with Solo. There's a lot of controversy surrounding Lucasfilm themselves, and how they deal with filmmakers, their ease with sacking directors and replacing filmmakers. It hasn't performed as well. It's not a failure by any stretch of the imagination, but it has underperformed ever so slightly for a Star Wars movie.
And is that the last one?
It is the last one of the Skywalker saga. There will be other ones. Obviously, they had an entire trilogy in the works with the two guys who made the Game of Thrones series. They were going to do sort of a Knights of the Old Republic type series. It was going to tell us how the Jedi got started. It was going to be a proper, you know, HBO fantasy epic kind of a thing, but done as a trilogy for the screen. Rian Johnson, who made The Last Jedi, has a trilogy of his own in the works as well. Kevin Feige, who runs Marvel, is producing a movie for them at some point. We've got an Obi-Wan series coming to...
Steady. There's too much overload here. Now, just take us away a little bit from Christmas. What can we expect coming up in the next 3 or 4 months? Because I'm one of those people, when I do go to cinema, and I love cinema, I must say, I sit in there, I see a trailer and think, I am going to see that film, and then completely forget about it. Because when they say it'll be launched in the summer of 2020, what have we got to look forward to? Is there anything that excites you out there?
I mean, I can say there is a film going out on New Year's Day that I expected very little from, that actually turned out to be really, really good. And against all odds, it's from a filmmaker I don't like very much. And it's Guy Ritchie's new film, The Gentleman. I thought that was great. Now, that's coming out New Year's Day. That's worth starting your year with, I think.
Oh, very good tip there. We are hearing the very best from you. Now, I'm being pretty cruel to all our guests who ring in here. Now, it's Christmas Eve. It's 9:13, okay? You have no chance of being able to buy a Christmas present that you have just realised you had forgotten. You could possibly go to a garage and pick up you could pick up a bottle of water and wrap it up nicely. Imagine you are in this crisis state. We are getting ideas from everyone tonight as to if you are now stuck at home thinking, my goodness, what do I do? Nick a chocolate bar from the house and wrap it up in paper and pretend it's a well thought through gift. What would your recommendation be to get an emergency gift?
Ooh, do you know what? I always get gig tickets. I'm not going to lie. I'd hop online. I always buy gig tickets for someone.
Yeah, no, I said to the team, no, he'll say download a cinema ticket or something like that. But, you see, I really ought to add, maybe your printer doesn't work. What are you going to do if you can't print it off then? How will you get around that one? Is there a way of sending it electronically and pretending it's a surprise?
Oh, absolutely. You can. You just set a delayed email. You can absolutely do that.
Right. You see, this just isn't good enough. You're all far too relaxed. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm from a different generation to get into. Van, fantastic. Thank you for your review. I know everyone who is going to go to the cinema, and we hear more and more people are going to go to the cinema. You've heard it here first, which ones to actually go and see. Now, coming up, we'll be having a little chat about how to make the most out of Christmas, tips and tricks with any sort of budget.